So in the morning before you leave for school, put a tampon in and wear a pad. Hey guys, it's Ev. This is kind of a weird angle, but I'm going with it. So these are tips that girls need for back to school. Tip number one will save you a lot of time when you're in the shower so that you won't have to be late to school in the morning, or so you'll be able to get to bed earlier if you shower at night. And that is to shave the bottom of your legs one day, and then the next day shave the top of your legs and keep alternating so you don't have to shave your whole leg every other day, etc. It'll just save you so much more time instead of shaving your whole leg, which those of you that don't have hair on the top of your legs, so jealous. And also when you're shaving, before you start to shave, like maybe you're like putting conditioner in, put the stopper in the tub and let some water fill up, and then turn the water off, and then you can shave with the water off while rinsing your razor in the water that you have in the bottom of the tub and by kind of like splashing your legs, if that makes sense, because you'll save some water that way, and you won't have like water like running down into your eyes while you're trying to shave. I don't know. There's a lawnmower, but I'm gonna speak over it. Tip number two will keep you smelling fresh all day when it's that time of the month. So in the morning before you leave for school, put a tampon in and wear a pad. And that way, maybe like halfway through the day, you can take the tampon out and keep having the pad all day. And that way you won't have to like do the whole like wrapper awkward noise thing during the day. And you can just get out of the bathroom and go. If you get terrible period cramps like I do, then get a note from your doctor saying that you can have ibuprofen in the nurse's office or in your backpack, depending on how your school does it. My school, I can't carry it in my backpack technically, but a lot of us do anyway. But you can keep a bottle at the nurse's office. If you get really bad cramps, you can go to the nurse and get your painkillers without getting in trouble. Another tip is to shower at night before you go to bed, because then you won't be late in the morning and it'll save you time. And then you can put deodorant on before you go to bed. This way, because a lot of us sweat at night, when you wake up, you won't have any weird smells from sleeping. You'll smell fresh, and you can always apply more in the morning before you go to school, but that way you'll just be fresh all day long. Another tip is to sleep with your hair in twists. And this is what I do when I want to have natural curls, because I don't have time to curl my hair in the morning and I don't want to damage my hair. So I sleep with my hair like this a lot of the time to have some pretty natural curls, and they come out awesome every time. Another tip to stay smelling fresh all day is to take your perfume and to put it on your pulse spots, like your wrists, whatever this part of your elbow is called, back of your knees, etc. And then don't rub it in, you'll kind of just like dab it. And apparently that helps like keep the whole scent there. I don't know, I'm not a beauty guru. If it's one of those days where you just feel like wearing sweatpants or yoga pants to school and not trying with your outfit, totally go for it. But just make sure that your hair and your skin still look awesome, because that way you will still look nice at school and you will feel more confident. So just take the time to make sure that your skin looks nice. Maybe just putting some concealer on. I like to wear like concealer with clear mascara, because then it doesn't rub everywhere, but I still look decent. I make sure that my hair is in a nice bun, a nice ponytail, or I have it like half up, half down, you know. Just make sure that your skin and your hair looks good, and that way you can wear like a frumpy outfit without looking homeless. Do not wash your hair every day. I know everyone's heard this already, but it's so true. I wash my hair like once or twice a week, and it still looks awesome. But that way, it'll just get used to not being greasy. I don't know, my hair stopped being greasy, and I've gotten to go longer periods of time without washing it, and it's awesome. And that way, you'll just save more time, and you'll be able to sleep better because your hair won't be wet, and you know, it's just all around a good thing. And also, it won't dry out your hair, so you won't have like ugly frizzy hair days. So you'll just have nice, pretty hair, because you know, gotta have the nice hair for school. This next tip is for how to deal with the mean girls. When someone says something bitchy to you, respond back with kindness. Your outfit sucks. Oh, huh, thanks. You always look stunning. You should give me some tips sometime. Mean girls want you to react, they want you to yell back at them, they want you to be sassy, they want to make you mad. So if you kill them with kindness, they won't know what to do. So anytime someone's mean to you, just say something kind back. About to spill the tea, girls. You do not need a boyfriend. I'm going into my senior year, have not ever had a boyfriend, have not been on a single date, and I'm still alive, I still have friends, all is well in the world. But seriously, just, you don't need to give in to peer pressure, anything. It doesn't even have to be just boys. You just
don't need to do those things.
You don't need to do drugs, you don't need to have sex, you don't need to have a boyfriend, you don't need to drink alcohol, you don't need any of those things to be happy and to have a good life. You know, do what you feel is right, live your life, and live for yourself and not for anyone else. Yes. don't be afraid to move away and separate yourself from friends. If there's those people that are just not good influences, they're being mean, they're kind of changed since you knew them in elementary school, just, you know, walk away.
Walk away!
They're probably not gonna be mad if, you know, you're not hanging out with them anymore because they have their new friends and you just don't fit in anymore. Don't feel bad about moving on. It's gonna happen. It's life.
Get over it.
And make some new good friends that'll actually last. My second to last tip is to just eat healthy foods. I know that's kind of like cliche, but if you eat healthy foods, you're going to feel better in your skin. Your skin's gonna look better. You're just gonna feel all over better. You're gonna have more energy, so you'll do better on your tests. You'll be more friendly with your friends. You won't need that morning coffee because you will just be healthy. You'll be going for it. So if you're just like getting some exercise, eating healthy, you will just feel better throughout. You'll look better and you'll just have a better time at school. And my last tip is to read the Bible every single day. I have an app on my phone that gives me a quote every day, and I have an app on my iPad that gives me a quote every night before I go to bed. And I have my Bible next to my bed, which I don't read that as often as I should because I just look at my phone, so start doing that. But reading a Bible quote every day is going to inspire you. It's going to remind you that Jesus loves you. He's there for you. He's going to help you make it through the day. He's going to help you go where you're supposed to go. So just read those Bible quotes. It'll help you be inspired. It'll help you feel closer to God. And you will be able to keep living your life and just being a good Christian, feeling awesome about yourself. Yes, read the Bible. And for me, a lot of the times, like when I pray, I always ask God to reveal himself to me every single day just so that I never have doubts. I can get over any doubts that I have. And a lot of the time, something happens in my day and then I get my Bible quote at night and it has something to do with what I was feeling with, what I was going through, and I know that God is answering my prayers because he just gave me that Bible verse that has to do with my life. So just read the Bible every day. It'll inspire you, and you know, just have faith that everything's gonna turn out the way it's supposed to, and have an awesome school year, okay? I love you all. Please subscribe to my channel if you want to see some new vlogs, college videos, applying to college, decision reactions, all that kind of stuff. And just, you know, have fun surviving high school. I can survive one last year. Let's do this together. Awesome girl squad. Let's go. One.